Hello everyone, and welcome to the Microsoft Security Update Summary, where I will present a short synopsis of what was released today, October 8th, 2024. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. I'm going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then I'll dive into a few of the vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities that I'm covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Now, before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months to see how it stacks up. With that, we have 118 newly disclosed vulnerabilities in today's release. It's a little bit higher than an average of just over 82 per month. Now, of those 118 total CVEs, 43 of them fall into the remote code execution impact. These are the type of vulnerabilities that typically provide the most risk, and we've been averaging just over 30 per month. Next, I'll talk about scoring, where Microsoft uses the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a scale between 0 and 10, where 10 presents the most risk. And the score here is a starting point when we talk about risk. It allows software vendors and hardware vendors to be able to put all their vulnerabilities on a singular scale, to be able to compare them across different products, different services, and even across vendors. That is, a 9.8 score on Windows is going to present the same risk as a 9.8 score in Office, or a 9.8 score with an Intel vulnerability, or a 9.8 score with a third-party open source software. This month, the highest score is 9.8 on that scale of 10, and we've been averaging right around 9.6 over the past 13 months. The average score across all of those 118 newly disclosed vulnerabilities comes in at 7.39, which is a little bit lower than our 13-month average of 7.5. Now, as I mentioned in this just a minute ago about the scoring, it's a starting place when we talk about risk. It does not contain everything there is when we talk about risk factors associated with the vulnerability. And one of those things that that the CVSS score doesn't cover is publicly disclosed vulnerabilities. This month we have 5. We've been averaging a little over 1.5 per month. These are vulnerabilities that were in one way or another disclosed prior to release, whether it's a security researcher blog, or maybe a Twitter post, or some other way where it's gone public prior to release. Another risk factor that's associated to a vulnerability but not represented in the CVSS score is whether that vulnerability is known to be exploited at the time of release. These are vulnerabilities where threat actors have already built exploit code and have already been using this in one way or another against customers. This month, there are 2 vulnerabilities that were known to be exploited at the time of release, and that's right at our average of 2 per month over the past 13 months. Okay, so that's it for the comparison of this release compared to the previous 12 months. Let's start looking at this release itself. Here's our overview chart, where we present the Windows products towards the bottom part of the chart, and then we move up into products that are not necessarily serviced every single month. We've been averaging mid to high 40s, depending on the specific operating system. And so this month, as we can see, we're well above that average. And again, that's due to the total number of vulnerabilities being higher than our average as well. As we move up the chart, we have SharePoint and Office with a small number of vulnerabilities. Visual Studio, .NET Framework, and .NET in our developer tools section, they have a handful of vulnerabilities. Defender for Endpoint for Linux has a vulnerability that's being addressed this month. Power BI Report Server and Microsoft Configuration Manager has a vulnerability in it this month that's being addressed. So let's take a look at this first vulnerability. This is CVE 2024-38124. This is an important elevation of privilege vulnerability, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 9.0 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is adjacent. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is low, and user interaction here is none. A threat actor who is able to leverage this vulnerability would be able to gain domain administrator privileges, which is pretty much the top of the type of privilege when we talk about on-prem privileges. There are some documented mitigations here that might be helpful in the time frame between now and when you're able to deploy this update to your domain controllers, but they might not all work for you. For example, this first one, avoid using predictable naming conventions. I mean, that's fairly subjective. what is non-predictable to you might just be happen to be able to be predictable unless you're giving random character names to your domain controllers. But these are kind of some best practices to keep in mind when we talk about domain controllers. The full fix here is to install the update on your domain controllers. Now, as far as the affected software, it's Server 2016, 2019, and Server 2022. There are no known workarounds for this vulnerability. The next vulnerability that I will talk to is CVE-2024-43572. This is an important remote code execution vulnerability in the Microsoft Management Console. This one was publicly disclosed and the exploitation has been detected at the time of release. It says a CVSS base score of 7.8. The attack vector is local. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is none, and user interaction here is required. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds. And as far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows that are in mainstream support, whether that's Windows 10 or 11 on the desktop side, or Server 2016, 2019, or Server 2022 on the server side. The next issue I'll talk to is CVE-2024-6197. This is a remote code execution vulnerability listed as important severity. This one is publicly disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This is a vulnerability in curl, which is an open source project that Microsoft consumes in Windows. It has a CVSS base score of 8.8. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. No privileges are required, but user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. There's no known mitigations or workarounds for this. As far as the affected software, it's Server 2019, Server 2022, Windows 10, and Windows 11. Finally, the last vulnerability that I will talk to in today's video is CVE-2024-43468. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in System Center Configuration Manager. This one was privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a CVSS base score of 9.8 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. No privileges are required, and no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this. So if you're using Configuration Manager in your environment, you're probably pretty aware of how to leverage these in-console updates. It's a pretty quick wizard that goes through and updates all your infrastructure, whether it's a management point, a distribution point. All those different pieces and parts will be updated through that little wizard. So the affected software here is Configuration Manager 2303, 2309, and 2403. One note I will point out on this is the update to address this vulnerability was released back in September on September 18th. So it's very possible that you may have already applied this update. So check out the CVE article where it shows the actual build number that the fix is applied to. And if you have installed the latest version of the Configuration Manager, there's no update for you there. You've already installed the update if you installed that September 18th update. Another thing I'll point out is Configuration Manager 2303. Today is the last date for servicing. So if you're using 2303, make sure to take the update from September 18th, and that'll keep you updated and current. But going forward, if there's any issues with 2303, it will be out of support after today. So you'll want to take action to upgrade your environment to either 2309 or 2403. If you're a Microsoft Premier or Unified Support customer and you would like to attend the full briefing call where we cover more content and are available to answer questions, you can either work with your CSAM to sign you up, or you can sign yourself up in Services Hub. Okay, that's all I have for you today. I want to thank you for taking time out of your day to watch this video, and I will talk to you all next month. Thank you.